I'm ready. Gotta make that change. What's up, guys? Today I'm checking out DJ Quick, Use a Gangsta. I'm definitely excited to check this one out. I love DJ Quick. I think his, I'm pretty sure he produces his own beats and whatnot. And he's an amazing, amazing artist, if you ask me. The three songs from him that I have heard, which are Dollars and Cents, Safe and Sound, Dollars and Cents, and it was another one. Oh, Just Like Compton. Those three songs, I listen to those like on an almost daily basis, and I really enjoy them. So I'm very excited to check out some more DJ Quick. So without further ado, and I know there's a music video up, I just don't feel like going through that whole process of trying to re-upload links and whatnot. So I'm just do this. But yeah, without further ado, DJ Quick, Use a Gangsta.
Psych. Oh no, it's 98, y'all.
98 too? Okay.
And we got some new shit.
Yes. Oh my. Off the bat, this beat is cold.
Fuck what you heard, baby. I'm DJ Quick. Whether on TV or in these streets, I'm still the shit. I went from drinking 8 Ball and making demos to drinking Hennessy and Chevy's Regal in the back of the limo. Getting my issue in life. You can't hate that, and when I tell you about yourself, nigga, you can't take that, cause y'all be cross-faced. If you don't understand, you got a side and I got one, but you be crossing over here to see what's in my hand. Yeah, but that's cool too. I guess my money on the double, that's what I do. Hitting them brown bubbles and avoiding trouble, hoes to choose, with nothing to lose. And a million motherfuckers wanna be in my shoes, but you don't understand. Beyond the parties and cheers, I've been broke my whole career, breaking bread with my peers. Bought a 96 Impala, the new double F. Before the 20,000 mile mark, I gave it to six. I can never bust a new shoe if my deputies ain't got it. Feel a jump man Cortez, yeah, I'm coming out the pocket. Put my homies in the hood up on it when I'm around. Cause there's a difference between being a thug and being down.
Very true. Very, very true. Bro, this song is dope. I like it. He's saying no, I'm not. To, don't mean that I do it. My occupation's a musician and I'm staying true to it. I went from being a rider to being a provider while I was straddling the fence, trying not to hit the divider. Just an impressionable human being trying to do right. Every now and then I get my man attested and fight. Like I used to have a beef with this cat named Ace, and his homies approached me at the club El Rey. What was I to do? I'm on stage and I'm doing my thing. And this nigga's out the crowd trying to hoop bang, giving it up for
that's
homies. Who that. Oh, wow. But he okay.
Like trash me. I wonder what's his problem, what he trying to say. Is this business personal or just fuck Quick Day? I approach him like a man and not like a nut. He turned around and put his drink down and straight knuckled up. In a dark club, punches is flying all around. And even though it was me and him, the rumors went round and said I killed somebody. Now how that sound? How could I slow somebody to death that's bigger than me and I'm just 155 pounds?
Wow, that was deep. Talked about the 8 Ball or MC8 8 Ball, the MC8 incident. Bruh, this song is cold. I love it.
See, some don't realize the power of lyrics, cause when you rap about death, you talking to spirits. You see, you can say the things that can help us all more, or you can say things that make it bad for us all. Fix the problem. The only way is come to the source. Don't be a Trojan horse. Help us change the course. Everybody knows that it's bad in the hood. So check what you rapping about if it ain't to the good. I did my part a long time ago. I changed my views. Ain't no gang banging or slanging, just hanging with truth. Give it up to my creator and that you can quote. But motherfuckers still see me as a scapegoat. Yeah, like that night with Biggie got a Quincy Jones spot. Like 400 other people, yeah, I heard some shots. Broke away with the crowd, nervous obviously. And the motherfuckers blamed it on me. What the hell?
Very interesting song.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not.
Most prolific writers in rap music history. Tupac Shakur
and Biggie Smalls.
Notorious B.I.G.
Yeah.
It's also dedicated to the little homie from the 60s that lost his life at that party. Rest in peace, y'all. And to MC8, when you get your hand together, maybe we can do a record. Feel me? I'm
So it's like, drop a light fresh spot. Definitely enjoyed this one. That beat was cold. I definitely enjoyed this one. DJ Quick essentially saying to MCA and to all the other rappers of that time to like just watch the message that they're spreading throughout the communities or the people who listen to their music, to watch that, and that he wanted to basically essentially end the whole MCA thing at the end. And it was kind of like he was just like kind of denouncing being a thug, and you know what I'm saying, you don't have to be a thug to be down and all that. Like he was putting it down. I definitely enjoyed this one. Had a kind of a conscious mindset, or a conscious it was conscious basically. It made you think about, you know what I'm saying, the stuff he was saying and how, you know what I'm saying, words really do have power. And yeah, it's definitely an amazing, wow, why am I stirring so much? Definitely an amazing song, definitely enjoyed it. DJ Quick is, yeah, he's amazing. I definitely enjoy listening to DJ Quick, and definitely enjoyed the song. And if you guys enjoyed the reaction, make sure you smack the like button, subscribe if you're new, and comment down below what the tracks, albums, or movies I should check out next time. And until then, much love, stay safe, and peace out.